हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माइसेल डॉक्टर सम्राट जानकर, एडवांस लैप्रोस्कोपिक कोलोरेक्टल एंड जीआई सर्जन, काइजन गैस्ट्रो केयर, पुणे। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी डिफरेंट ट्रीटमेंट मोडालिटी फॉर अकेलेसिया कार्डिया। देर इज नो अवेलेबल ट्रीटमेंट मोडालिटी येट टू रिस्टोर द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ अकेलेसिया कार्डिया, दैट इज डीजनरेशन ऑफ द नर्व फाइबर। None of the modality restore the normal LES function, or none of the modality restore the normal esophageal wall functioning, that is peristalsis. The intention of any kind of procedure or treatment is only to relieve the LES spasm, at the same time relieve the symptom of the patient, that is palliation of the swallowing problem will be done in akalasia treatment. The principle of any kind of treatment should beat two aspects. One is we need to relax the LES by doing the procedure. At the same time, we need to give anti-reflux measure so that after the relaxation of LES, if the reflux is going to happen, that should not cause the trouble in future. We need to add the anti-reflux procedure for any kind of treatment doing for the akalasia. Available treatment modality of akalasia can be divided into two types. One is non-surgical, which include medical treatment, Botox or balloon dilatation. Another one is surgical treatment. It may be a laparoscopic myotomy or endoscopic myotomy. If we are taking non-surgical treatment for treating the akalasia cardia, medical treatment and Botox treatment are limited use. They are only reserved for the patient who are unfit for any kind of procedure, bedridden patient, which may be needed to repeat in a frequent duration, that will have very limited success rate and very limited cure rate. Coming to the most important non-surgical modality, which was very famous 2 decades prior, that is endoscopic balloon dilatation. In this, the endoscopist pass the endoscopic balloon across the lower esophageal sphincter. Sequentially, he will dilate the endoscopic balloon, and because of dilatation of balloon at the GE junction area, which will rupture the fibers of muscles of lower esophageal sphincter, so that it will releases or relaxes the sphincter pressure significantly. It need to be done in multiple sessions to give better outcome in long term. But it is one of the crude method of treating the akalasia cardia. Here, multiple muscle fiber are divided at multiple level. Risk of perforation is very high. At the same time, the recurrence of the symptom are known for higher in endoscopic balloon dilatation, and it does not add anti-reflux procedure, so that in spite of getting good relief from the dysphagia or swallowing difficulty, patient is bound to get reflux in significant amount in the post-operative period. Coming to surgical methods of treating akalasia cardia, the surgical methods are mainly mean to divide the muscles of the lower esophageal sphincter and muscles of the esophagus, also some parts of the stomach, so that division of the muscles, circular muscles, will lead to relaxation of the lower esophageal sphincter, which will help to relieve the symptom of swallowing difficulty in these patients of akalasia. Coming to a first laparoscopic Hellers myotomy, in this procedure, a laparoscopic surgeon put the small button holes over the abdomen to go inside the abdomen, and inside the abdomen, under 20 times magnified view, high definition of the camera, with available sophisticated energy devices, he will divide the circular muscle and he will relieve the esophageal sphincter pressure. By relief of the esophageal sphincter pressure, patient will have very good outcome, and patient will have good relief from the symptom. And at the same time, surgeon can do the anti-reflux procedure, which will help to avoid the regurgitation of the acid after the surgery into the stomach. At the same time, if at all, the one of the known dreaded complication of the myotomy by any kind of instrument is the injury to the mucosa, which will leak the food into the abdomen, which can be detected on table by laparoscopy and also can be corrected by taking few of the stitches, and adding the door fundoplication in this kind of complication will not allow patient to suffer from the trouble. Coming to next available modality is endoscopic treatment for endoscopic myotomy for the case of achalasia, which is peroral endoscopic myotomy, where by using the endoscopy create the submucosal tunnel, and from there the endoscopist reach to the muscle layers of the lower esophageal sphincter. Sequentially division of the muscle layer in the esophagus and lower esophageal sphincter and some parts of the stomach significantly give relief from the symptoms of achalasia, and patient will have great relief. But there will be a problem related to a reflux, because muscles are mean for the avoiding a reflux from the stomach, into the esophagus are divided. A significant problem of reflux has been noted in peroral endoscopic myotomy. If we are doing peroral endoscopic myotomy, suffering with the reflux may need the anti-reflux procedure later in the period of life. So, available options of the treatment modality of achalasia should be tailored as per the need of the patient and should be used with the principles of achalasia treatment. Thank you.